What the heck is going on with you? CONCORDE, why? What are you doing? Oh my gosh. That was weird. All you have to do is stay a minute. Just take your time. The clock is ticking, so stay. All you have to do is play a second. And welcome back to another Star Stable Let's Play video. My name is Stella Pinkbird, and today we are going to be checking out a new Soul Rider quest, as well as the Soul Riders, not that, as well as the Soul Riders new. I do not know my way around it. Here, we have to go to Elizabeth Sunbeam, sorry, in a secret in Mystic Place only the Cubes of 18, which is the secret stone circle. Yeah, so we're going to be checking out the new Soul Rider quest, but first let's get our horse. Because we are doing the... I've left the gate open! Or the stall door, whatever you call it. I don't know much about horses myself, and stables and stuff. But I've left that open. And because we are doing the Soul Rider stuff, I like to get out my trusty steed, Star Magic. So come on, Star Magic, my beautiful starter horse, my beautiful Yorvik One Blood. Let's do what we always do at the start of a Star Stable video, and let's give you a wash. And first, let's wash you down. Oh, no, I didn't mean to do that, I'm sorry. Why is the tap still running? And that's the switch sides there, and then the soap, and then the water again, and then the grooming. Now we're done. Let's just put your tack on. I feel so much better when my backpack is like all clear of everything, because before the video my backpack was stuffed, and there's this girl who keeps talking, and she's just like, what? So this girl's just like, she's like constantly wanting to talk, and like it's sort of annoying me. So yeah, let's get to the video. Hang on! Did I not? Oh, hang on. There we go. Saba, can you fix that, please? I don't know how you say it. the disappearing of horse tack. Okay, so let's go over to... Hang on. You know what I'm gonna do, guys. I always forget to do that! I always forget to turn the music off. Oh, and these two. Sorry guys, I'm a bit excited and at the same time unprepared. Okay, so hang on, I'm just gonna check if I'm still recording. Yeah, we're still recording. Okay, so let's go around here. Nah. Oh good, it still works. Sort of hard to control my mouse. Oh it didn't work. Let me just do that again. I was looking back to watch it disappear, and this happened. Never look back, guys. That's a lesson in life. Don't look back, don't you ever do that. Don't look back. Tina Arena. Okay. Yeah, supposed to make that noise before you can. Oh, okay, I'm so excited. I haven't actually basically just logged on, and I haven't seen what the... tin can? You're so... Okay, so I'm just gonna do like a little review on these guys. So he kind of looks like a Yorvik pony. He's so cute. Hi, Tin Can. How are you doing? And Starshine, oh my gosh, you are just beautiful. Now, let me see. You know what, you kind of look like, you kind of look like these guys. Oh, you're just beautiful. And let's take a look at Meteor. Now, he looks like a North Swedish horse. Oh, he's just fab. They all are. They are just gorgeous. I'm gonna have this as a thumbnail. Hang on. Oh no, I've done it again. You know what, just don't worry about it. Where do I go? Oh yeah, that's right here. Oh, that's right. I cannot enter this with my horse. I'm so stupid. Okay, let's go. Wonder what the Soul Riders look like. I've seen pictures of them, but Alex, my main girl. You've changed. Oh my gosh, look at her. Like, she's got determination in her eyes. Like, just, she's got a bit of a smirk there as well. Just look at you. She's got like a cardigan, and she's got like, she's got one glove on. She's got headphones and like a beanie. Cool. And I just noticed like her beanie. Her beanie has a lightning on it, and she's part of the lightning circle. And why does she have grey eyes? Does she always have grey eyes? Grey eyes. Okay, so let's see. Linda. I kind of liked her better with brown hair and a ponytail, and she's got like a necklace on. And Knights of Unistria. Oh yeah, that's like a book Star Stables had. And hang on, what's this? And she's got like hair clips or something. Like, she just looks like a nerd. She looks like a nerd. And let's see Lisa. Okay, Lisa. Oh, you just blinked. Ooh, you're very pretty, but torn jeans. Like, what's the thing with that? And I like your necklace. Got earrings. Lisa, I reckon she's the prettiest. And she's got like a bandana on. Yeah, I'm pretty sure that she comes from Texas. I think that's what they said about her. So yeah, like, she's really expressed that with the bandana. I just don't know much about Texas in America, but like, I do know that's like, I think it's supposed to be like cowboyish or something like that, and the bandana expresses that. I think that's what I think, but correct me if I'm wrong. Okay, so let's start this. It is almost time to assemble at the portal in Guardian's Dale. Okay. checking with her. Okay. But we have Oh wow, they're so much more expressive. But we have Concord. What are we waiting for? We need the new keystone. Stella, you and Evergrey were seeing to that, weren't you? You nod. Why can't you just like make us talk? And like, it'd be cool if we could like sort of like when we say in the, like when we write in the chat, you want to talk or whatever, like, we'd be doing that action. That'd be cool. Then Stella and Evergrey will bring the keystone to Guardian's Dale. Where is my brother anyway? I haven't seen him since the business at the circus. Perhaps he's with Rhiannon. I can never really say that. Perhaps he's with Rhiannon and Concord at the mountain paddock. Come on, Stella, let's find out and meet you there. I always liked Alex. She's an adventurous fighting type. I like those type of characters. Why is this still bright? Oh, I can't get over these guys. They're so beautiful. I love them. So where do I have to meet? Oh yeah, at the mountain paddock. Yeah, wrong way, Star Magic. Come in this way. Star Magic, you remember Concord, right? He's that little foal. I haven't actually been up there in ages. Not since I did the video where the Star Horses had the update. Now, I haven't been up there since. So, I wonder if Concorde has changed at all.
Oh, I haven't really seen the update up here. It looks so much more pretty. Ah, Concorde! Ah. Oh, he's loving it.
He's enjoying himself. Oh, hi, Brianan. Stella, Alex, I'm glad you're here. A little guardian of the sun circle is being a major pain in the butt. Oh, okay, he's being cheeky. Because, like, I've got, oh, not really me, but, like, my mum has a little puppy. She's 8 months old. Her name's Grace, and I tell you what, she's so full of personality. Like, whenever, she sees life as a game, you might as well say, because she, like, whenever she's outside, and I'll try to pick her up, and she'll just run away from me, and I end up chasing her and stuff. So it's kind of annoying. What the heck is going on with you? God, why? What are you doing? Oh my gosh. That was weird. Okay, I've encountered spirited foals before, but not like this. Maybe you could try calming Concorde down, Stella. Okay, a soul searching. Help calm Concorde. What does Concorde mean? I'd like to know that. You really love it? This is like me chasing Grace in real life. Hello. Ah, cuddle! Cuddle! Save some snuggles for the rest of us. Did Circus Bay do a little snippy on Concorde? Because he seems to be missing his stallion stones. Alex, I guess there's no reason why a guardian couldn't be gelding, right? I mean, we're sole riders, not sole breeders. Alex, of course Anne is gonna be... Oh, it's gonna be annoyed when she finds out that. That's a bad word, that. So I don't like how they've done that. Alex, Concorde is a mare. What? What? Oh! Concorde is a girl? Concorde is a girl? What? But for real, I thought the guardians were always male. Records of guardians being born as mares are rare, but not unheard of. A soul is not defined by the gender it's born into. Da-da-da-da-da. And Alex, please never say stallion stones again. Poor Concorde. Her soul knows that this is a pivotal moment when the soul riders must unite. She seeks a soul to bond with. You mean Anne? She wants Anne, right? If Anne were here on Jorvik, I do not doubt it. But from where Anne is, I don't know. And I'm just going to see if I'm still recording. We have to keep Concorde close and make sure she does not have the chance to form a bond with anyone else stronger in the Sun Circle. Should that happen, the sisterhood that formed 3 years ago will be irrevocably broken in this battle, if not the war for Jorvik. Is lost. So me and I have to stay away from her because I'm pretty strong in all of them. So what brought you up here? Okay, yeah, you just asked that now. Hi, Concorde, you little girl. Hi. She's so cute. Okay, Evergrey, he's not the sacred stone circle. Come to think of it, I haven't seen him since Concorde's rescue. Looking for Ev. This is a little nickname for him. Maybe he's still in Silverglade. I hear that he and the clockmaker seem to hit it off. Yeah, I've actually seen him a couple of times there. Evergrey and Bonnie, you don't think they're... I'm a wild whisperer. Horses I get. People, who knows what's going on with those two. Stella, you can take things from here, right? I'm going to stay here and help keep Concorde out of trouble. Okay, it's probably best I go anyway. I don't want Concorde bond with me. And not Anne when we rescue her. Speaking of which, when are we going to rescue Anne? She's... Poor thing, she's been in Pandoria for who knows how long. Wait, what am I doing? Shortcut. So, Silverglade. I still can't believe Concorde's a girl. I mean, I like the idea, but like Alex said, I thought they're all supposed to be male. I thought they're all supposed to be boys. Oh, Dextra! Dextra! Hi! Hello! Oh, she just... Oh, okay. I see how it is. Right, this is where I saw them last. Yep. Okay, oh, sorry. I just bumped my camera. I'm sorry. Not now, Stella. Whatever it is you need, I cannot possibly be as important. You cannot possibly be as important as what's going on here. Or what's so important? Actually, I could use your assistance. Drop everything you're doing. I need a potato. What's it with you, star stapling? Whatever you call yourselves. What's it with you guys in potatoes? What's it with people in potatoes? I recognize the irony, Stella, sending you in search of produce when a friend's life is in the balance. On the surface, this is precisely the sort of urbane logic that drove me into exile. But I assure you, this time is different. The fate of Anne von Blissen, is that her name? Blissen, whatever. If not, the very universe depends on it. Supermarket spuds will not do. The fresher the potato, the better. But curse our luck, we're off season. Well, you'll have to check with Molly and pray to Aideen that we're not too late. Okay, what could he possibly need potatoes for? Oops. Whee! Hi, Stella, what are you doing here? The other girl. A potato? I wish I could help, but the season's over, Stella. The field is picked over and then some. And then, what? You're welcome to have another look. I said as much to the other girl just a few minutes ago. The other girl? Oh, I have to look at the thing. Thingamabob. Sonia? That really you? The potato's mine. Is that Sonia from the forest? And she has a fjord. If you need a potato, look somewhere else. Molly promised me this one. Why do you need that potato? Hot potato. Not that it's any business of yours, but I'm training for the potato race. You tell us, Sonia. Isn't the potato race months away? I need the potato for something much more important than a silly race. Do you really need the potato in order... Isn't the potato... Yeah. Do you take me for an amateur? Champions train for the potato race all year long. Oh, good point. Seriously, I could win the potato race with eyes closed. Seriously, if I don't get the potato, people could die. I could use it. Big words, but are you prepared to prove it? According to the rules laid forth in the Farmer's Codex, I challenge you to a potato race. To the winner goes the spud, and the ultimate honor, do you accept? Prepare to meet your mashed, Sonia. Yeah, I'll say. I love that sound effect. This is gonna be fun. I haven't done the potato race in ages. Sorry. What? No way. Change of rules. First back wins. Okay. Star magic's faster than you, Sonia. I'll show you. How did you get here? Doesn't matter. You're worth a competitor, Stella. I don't know how you say that. I seed the potatoes. However you say it. Like, now I had feelings about the duel, right? I can get a bit carried away with my competitiveness. Emma says I should channel it into a riding club. Perhaps it is time I joined one or started one. Until next time, Stella. Enjoy your potato. You earned it. Fries on the prize. Fries, because you know, fries are made of potatoes and like, yeah, whatever. Okay. Okay, Ever Grey, here's your potato. Here's your potato. I trust you succeeded on your mission. I hate it when you're talking and then you trip over your tongue. Let me examine the potato, Frybrun. Good starch ratio, nice tight skin, no blemishes that I can make out. I'll give Mally this, even the dregs of his field are specimens of the highest order. This will do nicely. So, Ev, are you finally going to tell the poor girl what this urgent potato crisis is all about? Sorry, of course. Think of the potato as a keystone, and this device as the portal steering device from Guardian's Dale. The missing statue, the fifth that will show the way. Oh yeah, I remember a while ago, like when with the other Soulrider quests, I recorded a video. Like, this is before I started YouTube. It's like when I attempted to do my first video. I recorded that quest, and in Guardian's Dale, near Hillcrest, there was like these statues of these horses, and one was like missing. Keystone is crafted using druid magic. Oh, the potato is the key? How is that? How does that work? The portal network was built by Pandorians many centuries ago using magic and technology of a wholly different sort. Think AM and FM, Mac and PCs, Swedes and Norwegians. They seem similar enough on the outside, but they're on totally different wavelengths. I don't even know what AM and FM is, but I know Macs and PCs, and those, the Swedes and Norwegians. In order for the two devices to communicate, we must carefully modulate the energy flow. If the flow is just the tiniest bit off, instead of a stable portal, we'll create a dimensional event that could irrevocably shatter the barrier between Earth and Pandora, ushering forth the destruction of both worlds. Then why are you doing this then? It's the potato. I was getting to that part. We will use the potato for a dry run, a fry run, if you will, to test my theories on magical flow modulation. The potato, you see, has distinctive chemical energy signature that my device will attempt to interface with. Like a potato clock. This is nothing like that juvenile horological knick-knack. Sorry, Ev, I call it like I see it. When you've got there, it's a fancy druid mojo potato clock, and I can tell you right now, it's... Now, Bonnie, not everything comes back to clocks. This is entirely different. Stella, I'll let you have the honor of placing the test tuber. Come closer, Bonnie. This you'll want to see. I think I'll just stand back here. Yeah, I would if I were you, if I wasn't doing it. Have I got the potato? Yeah, I do. Nice potato from the fields. Potato. I thought you said you were going to stay back, Bonnie. Oh, classic! Oh my gosh. Starstar really has a sense of humor. There goes the universe. It could have been worse, Stella. Much worse. We could have opened a rift to the potato dimension. Yeah, sure, they have a thing. They have like a mod like that in Minecraft. But I didn't know that was actually an actual thing. Back to the drawing board, sigh.